Welcome to Community Balance, and I'm Suzanne Barnett, your host, and I am so pleased to present our famous guest tonight, Connie Young Yu. Connie is a historian and an author of Chinatown, San Jose, USA, and here she is. Connie, I am so thrilled to meet you.
Well, thank you, Suzanne. I'm not usually called famous, but I'm a local historian, so there.
No, I know, but you've been so active in the Asian and Chinese American communities, and you've written so many publications on these issues, and tell what you really are, too. Go ahead.
Well, I think that when I was in college, I was an English major at Mills College. I wanted to write stories. I wanted to be a novelist. And then when all that the activism happened in the Bay Area, I just realized there are issues to be writing about. I just forgot all about those stories and started getting involved with community things. One early project I was involved in was saving the barracks on Angel Island. And this was in 1974. And I was part of just a citizens group, just a group of young activists who said, you know, we've got to save those barracks because there's a lot of history there. And actually, I don't think we really believed we'd be that successful. But we are, this year, we are celebrating the 100th anniversary of the Angel Island Immigration Station. There is a foundation. It is a state park. It is a national site, Ellis Island of the West. But actually, the history of Angel Island is one of struggle. My grandmother was detained there for a year and a half.
Really?
And that's because of the Chinese exclusion laws. So from that experience, I learned about activism, but also I started making connections between my own family and the struggles that Chinese had, and you know, the fact that my grandmother, who was married to a U.S. citizen, was detained in the barracks on Angel Island for that long, from January 1924 to April 1925. I mean, this was very big in our family history because it affected my mother so much and her siblings, and it became actually a court case. So from that, I started doing more writing. I wrote about it. I wrote about it in an essay called The World of Our Grandmothers in an anthology called Making Waves, Asian American Women's Writings. So I never thought that was one of my early publications.
So you are very famous. And the subject tonight is digging to Chinatown.
That's correct. I mean, I went from sort of the broader topic of Asian America, the struggles of, you know, Japanese, Chinese, Filipino, other Asian groups through Angel Island to a very a local Chinatown that my grandfather, this is my grandfather.
Yeah, and such a handsome.
Thank you.
Handsome. How old was he in that picture?
Well, he was in his 20s, and this is one of those identification pictures he had to take, the Chinese had to carry, like a photo passport. Mm-hmm. My grandfather came in 1881, as a 11-year-old laborer, came right to Chinatown, to San Jose Chinatown, which was the site of the Fairmont Hotels, where the Fairmont Hotel stands now. And I got involved because of progress and what do they call the Environmental Protection Act, where you people just can't just dig up and develop things without doing some study. You know, the environmental impact and some historical consultants have to be called. But when the Fairmont was excavated, they found remnants of a Chinatown. The Chinatown was burned to the ground by arson. My grandfather was in that Chinatown during that time.
Right.
And he was a teenager, and he was driven out. And we have a picture, you know, we have pictures that appeared in Harper's in those times. They didn't have photographs of Chinese being driven out. We have one here, actually, of the Chinese are, as soon as they arrive, they're being stoned and pursued. And up and down the Pacific coast during the 1880s, 1870s, 1880s, 1890s, Chinatowns were burned to the ground. And one of the Chinatowns, and this is very, it's not very well known, was in San Jose. So when you go to the Fairmont Hotel, there is a plaque there that said, on this site, May 4th, 1887, a Chinatown was burned to the ground by arson. And it was home to families, working people, farmers, people like my grandfather.
So do you feel that because of your ancestors and your family, that this has really given you such impetus to do what you're doing?
Wow.
What do you think?
Yes, Suzanne, that, I think you nailed it. Yes,
I think so.
It is true that when I first started writing, it was much more objective. It was like, you know, this is what happened. It was like what activists do. You know, you write about some injustices of the past. And as I got closer to it, and, you know, I'm very, very fortunate. My parents, my mother born in San Francisco and my father in San Jose, they experienced some of these struggles. And they saved the memorabilia. They saved papers. They saved these photographs. They saved documents. And so as I got closer to researching the truth, I mean, you know, these are firsthand accounts, even though it passed through oral history, I started writing about my family. It became much more about my family.